The Institute started in 1979. It arose out of a call from the National Science Foundation for a proposal from anywhere in the physics community in the United States for something different that would support theoretical physics.
Well, the Gang of Four were a bunch of young, at that time, young professors in the physics department. They really took advantage of this proposal to come up with a very innovative structure. Part of the plan was to bring in new people, including Walter Cohn, who became the first director. They helped a lot in the beginning of the ITP, formulating its structure and helping it get started.
The founders wrote the proposal to the NSF with a certain vision. And that vision is what the Institute is today and what it will continue to be forever. It's a vision of an institute where collaborative research is highlighted and nurtured. And that's what really initiated Fred Kavli to do the initial gift. He always had a strong desire to give back in a philanthropic way to science in general, specifically physics. As we interacted with Fred, he came to appreciate our style and what we were doing. The main activity at the Institute are what we refer to as programs, which are long periods of sustained research that people come from all around the world to participate in. And our intent and our goal of those programs is to define a focus in scientific research and clear them of all their other duties by pulling them away from their home institutions, that they will actually make different types of progress.
Our Physics Munger residence was designed specifically for housing physicists. They're spending time not only in the classroom when they're here during the days, but they're also able to continue those conversations and relationship building throughout the whole weekend and evening times together. And then they go back to their home institutions. They have those relationships. They have a new network that they've strengthened and built their own careers.
The thing about the Institute is its openness and the breadth with which it approaches science. There are all these different ideas in the air, so you just breathe them in. We have hundreds of biologists coming to this theoretical physics institute, and they get introduced to the way physicists think and the way theoretical physicists go about science. And the institute is just a great place to build bridges and break barriers.
KITP has played a tremendous role as an incubator for the absolute best young people. These individuals grew up through the KITP and its unique melting pot of communities. And that has had an enormous influence. These are the people populating the best universities, best research labs around the country and around the globe now. And they're also vital to the functioning of the Institute. When they're here, they're the lifeblood, the energy, the base level of activity of the Institute is due to these young people.
It's very easy when you do research to get over-specialized, but at KITP is much more aware of what other scientists are doing, and it has made me more open to explore other research directions in my work.
You know, it's almost like celebrity scientists over here. You know, that's again an opportunity you don't always get. But no matter the stature of the scientists, or how old or young, or how accomplished they are, everyone's on a level playing field here in terms of interaction. So you can learn from the absolute best. And that's something that's not available in many places.
I cannot imagine what my career would be like without this program, because I learned so much. And it's hard to think about taking away the amount of knowledge and experience and networking I learned from KITP.
Finding young people in science is very important because this is the next generations of researchers and scientists that are going to push the frontier of science, push our understanding of the world. And this is really the only way that we can progress humankind and the only way that we can make sure that our life today and in the next generations are better.
You know, I'm really proud of what this KITP has accomplished. The impact went way beyond just the Theoretical Physics Institute here and affected science around the world. The work that goes on here, it's arguably could be the work that shapes the direction that theoretical physics takes over the decade. That's quite a remarkable achievement.
More than 1,000 people are here studying at the KITP. These are people that come here from all over the world, and they're taking the knowledge that they've gained here and sharing it with others and creating this wonderful potpourri of information. And every day something exciting is happening.
People like to ask me, what's the future of the Institute? To me, that's the same question I'm asking, what's the future of physics? I can't predict what are going to be the physics problems 40, 50 years from now. I'm just confident that whatever they are, they'll be happening here. We represent what the community sees as the future. You know, if you really want to upset physicists in the country or in the world, you would say the KITP is closed. The whole physics community across the world views this as a resource. And for that reason, it is a place that must go on forever.
You're supporting some of the most creative, interesting, exciting people in the world. That's an unusual thing to support. Scientific discoveries last forever.